Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today I am participating in the monthly Mixed Media Mayhem Hop and I am scrap lifting this wonderful layout by Shauna Rollins. And what I'm doing here is I've got my Tim Holtz Distress Oxides and I am using this wonderful Mickey Mouse stencil from Scrapping Reflections, and I am putting the colors of the traditional Disney colors, the red, black, and yellow, and I'm just making kind of some straight lines to kind of mimic the way it was on the original layout. I'm going to be working on, surprise, surprise, a Disney layout, and so that's kind of the final results, and I've got my Mickey heads, and they're ready to go, and because this was ink, it's pretty easy to dry quickly, and so what I have decided to do, which is kind of weird for me, I am going to stay with one collection, and this is the Doodlebug, I believe it's called At the Park collection, and so I'm going to go ahead and cut out one of these cut-apart sheets, and I'm going to use some of my ephemera pack, my die-cut pack, add some stickers to it, and that's really going to be the bulk of my layout. I almost never, ever, ever use just one collection, and so I decided to sort of challenge myself. I know a lot of people do just use one collection. I typically do not, and so I thought I would sort of challenge myself to see what I could make of this. Now, this is a picture that we had taken last December, or actually December 2021, at the bus stop, and so I decided that since I only had this one photo, I would highlight that because standing in line at the bus stop, if you have ever gone to the Disney parks and stayed at one of the resorts, that is a big part of your time at the parks. And so I thought it was worth documenting that we're up, we're ready to go, it's early, and you can see my son in the layout is just not thrilled at all by the thought of getting up early to go to the parks, and so it was fun to kind of capture that. Now, one of the things you'll see over to the left, I had purchased these fun foam shapes a long, long time ago. They're self-adhesive, and I have used them so much for dimensional adhesive. It was really inexpensive, and so I guess if you kind of want a little hack, there is one that you can buy these fun foam shapes, and you have they'll stick to whatever you want to be popped up. And I really did want to add a little bit of dimension because, like I said, I'm going to be using clusters here and trying to use everything from the same collection. And so I really did want to add a little bit of dimension there. I have sort of that tram, which I'm going to consider our bus because I did not have a bus to put on my layout. And then some stickers around as well. I'm going to continue to just kind of build up my clusters here. I'm looking at that sticker sheet, and I have to tell you, there just wasn't a lot that was really bus themed on here. I tried really hard, you guys, to find a lot of stickers. I think that might be a fun thing for me to do for maybe a Magic Kingdom layout. There's a lot of Magic Kingdom stuff that is part of that sticker sheet, and so maybe I will challenge myself at another time to try and use up most of that sticker sheet. So now I'm just kind of looking through my titles and ephemera pack, and this is where I go a little bit rogue on the scrap lift. I saw those banners and I thought, you know what, that would look really cute up there. I don't use banners a whole lot, but I thought, you know what, let's just add that. There's a little bit of blue in that sign, and then some of my die cuts, and so I wanted to kind of carry that blue up a little bit. It strays a little bit from the traditional Disney colors, but I'm okay with that. So I saw that great big word adventure, and I decided that was going to be part of my title. I'm just kind of looking through here to see if there's anything else that I wanted to add there. There are a whole bunch of words, and as I'm kind of looking through this, I'm thinking to myself, you know, You could take a whole package of these die-cut words and really make a fun background. And so, as I'm looking at this, I'm getting kind of inspired of different ways to use up my stash. And so, I'm gonna have to look through some of my more generic Disney pictures and see if I can give you guys some examples of that, of how to use up some of this stash. Because you do get a lot in there, and that's one of the things when I saw this whole kit from Doodlebug, I thought, wow, there is just so much stuff there that this could really go a long way. And so I will see if I can complete that as well. I know on Tuesdays we do our stash dive, and so maybe we'll look at some Tuesdays doing that. Now I'm going to go ahead and use that fun foam again to pop up my word there. And I do have those little epoxy stars that I want to use as well. I put it down there and I forgot, okay, it's only adhesive on one side. So I do have to end up gluing that adventure down. And I'm going to put those stars around and just kind of add a little bit of interest. I had some hearts. I'm going to add some stars. I really love these epoxy stars. Doodlebug does such a great job of giving you so much variety in their collections, and I really love that. And now I'm going to use my favorite letter stickers from Studio Calico, the Color Story collection, and add in my title, which will be Adventure Begins at the Bus Stop. And that is going to be it. Thanks so much for stopping by. If you like this video, I would love it if you'd hit that thumbs up. If you're not yet a subscriber, make sure you hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so that you're alerted when I have new videos up. Make sure you're checking out everybody's videos in this hop, and I will see you next time. Have a magical day. Bye-bye.